the book as it's written starts when Blanche is 14 years old. She is from a very small town of 100 people in the middle of the corn stalks of the farms of Illinois. And suddenly she is put on an orphan train and sent to St. Louis, Missouri.
There's a lot of significance to the title and then the influence that that title exerts on the rest of the book. So can you talk about that?
This is the original Bonnet Book. This is a 118-year-old address book. You can see the initials on the side. So this is the book of Blanche's notes from her hat-making school. In this is the diary. It has other things in it. It has sayings for how to take care of your life. It has about 28 pages of notes related to hat-making. It has 25 sketches. As you can see, the sketches here in the book. And I held this in my hand and said, why, this is the Bonnet Book.
But, you know, you just mentioned it's not a Cinderella story, but, you know, when your grandma gets to, when Blanche gets to St. Louis, as everyone in the book club knows who's read the book, circumstances are pretty bad. She is living in a pantry. It is essentially pretty close to, if not servitude. And it's through hat making, like you mentioned in the introduction, that she sort of finds her freedom and is able to change her circumstances. So can you tell us a little bit about what you learned? Because you had to do a lot of research. You've mentioned a lot of the family research that you've done. You mentioned the carriage research, which we are going to talk about. But tell us a little bit about what you learned about hat making, because it's so central, obviously, to the book.
When I knew my grandmother as a young child, she had a store in Illinois and she was selling hats. She had hat racks in the back and all the hats in the rack were hats that she made. So I knew from early in my childhood that she was a maker of hats. I did not visit this concept as an adult until I started writing this book. There's a postcard of the Rosenthal Sloan Company in St. Louis. This is the company to which the Roby family sent her for hat making. And it turns out that Rosenthal Sloan was one of the largest suppliers in the world of hat making supplies. So she ended up in the right city at the right time to be exposed to a really good company that was getting supplies from all over the world. I began to research online what I could find out about other kinds of hats. I found a woman in Texas who is French, who is making hats that her grandmother in Paris taught her to make. And I bought one of her hats. Hat makers would take the basic hat and adorn it. This one has a blue undercoating covered with lace. Then it has feathers in the front here and little silk flowers under that and a tulle bow in the back and a very long tulle bow. So I kind of copied this format in some of the hats that were in the opening night show.
Being out in the field required facing some dangers and being able to protect herself. And so you did some extra hands-on research so that you could represent that authentically in the book.
I rode to two artillery ranges on the peninsula here. One of them never answered me. The other one did answer me, a lovely, wonderful man named Carl Gross. I told him over the internet what I was looking for and that I needed to learn about guns and maybe I needed a shooting lesson. So I met Carl down at the Sunnyvale Rod and Gun Club. We went into the parking lot and he opened his trunk and laid out a whole set of historical guns from the era of 1900. And I sort of picked the one I like, and that's the one that I described in the book. Then he said, okay, now we're going to go in and teach you to shoot. And it was early in the morning. We were the first people there. So I had 2 hours to learn how to shoot. And when I first picked up this gun, I said to myself, it's as heavy as a brick. At any rate, we spent 2 hours and I learned to shoot the gun. Then I thanked Carl Gross and I ran back home and wrote it all down. And then I sent it to Carl for review. And so the shooting lesson is in the book. And that's how Bonnie learned to shoot.
Are you packing today?
No, I'm not packing.
No. Okay. All right.